Do not cut off ties with those who hate you because of me. Wednesday, June 25, 2014 at 11:37 p.m. My dearly beloved daughter, there is no need for people to stop all their normal day-to-day activities when they pledge allegiance to me. I am not a God that commands you to fall down at my feet, to the detriment of your daily responsibilities. I do not preen, stand majestically, with a proud demeanor, to rule the human race, nor do I dictate your every move or try to stifle you into subservience to me. That is not who I am, for I came as a humble servant to free man from bondage to the devil. I came to save you and I come again to complete my plan of salvation. I am here to serve you. I come to draw you to me and while I delight in your love for me and the time you devote to me, my intention is to do this in a way which does not cause you undue distress. While I welcome the time you give to me and the prayers you offer up, you still have to live your lives in order to feed and clothe yourselves and your families. All I ask is that you live your lives in the way that is necessary in order to serve me. And as your relationship with me deepens, you will feel a compelling desire to speak with me through your thoughts and words. I ask that you treat others with the respect that you show me. Do not argue or lose your temper with others over me. Never justify the actions or words, however, of those who insult me, just pray for them. As your love for me grows, your relationship with me will become more intimate. When that happens, that will be the time when you will draw down upon you the wrath of those whose faith is weak. Expect this to happen and do not be alarmed or distressed, for when you are in union with me, then you will be hated for this. Be patient with these people. Be kind. Be polite. Do not bother to argue, for nothing you say will make a difference. Instead, show them the meaning of Christianity by responding to hatred with love. Do not cut off ties with those who hate you because of me. Instead, please pray for them. You must try to keep a balance in your life when you are in union with me. While I desire your company, I also desire that you love those who need me, but who cannot see me, who cannot find it in their hearts to accept me or who have no concept of what eternal life means. Your duty is to me and my desire is that you use your time wisely to love these souls. Through your words, deeds, actions and prayers, you can and will bring me these souls. Dear Jesus.